Glazbeni napal. Kultur šok. Seattle Sound, Nirvana, Pearl Jam, Soundgarden, Alice in Chains i onda na kraju kulturni šok. Šta nam možete reći o tome?
Mi smo došli poslije svega toga. Mi smo počeli 1996. godine kada je kada Nirvana nije postojala, Soundgarden se upravo gasio, još jedne godine dana je postojala, gasio se, Pearl Jam još uvijek postoji. Seattle Sound je još uvijek tu negdje, jer onaj nije stvar u sound, stvar je u tome u neoperčenosti, ja mislim. U tome da muzičar su sebe prestali ozbiljno da shvataju i sviraju zato što im je drago da sviraju, zbog toga da bi postali bogati i slavni.
Možemo dakle slobodno reći da je to način života, stil života.
So you can say it's a way of life, a lifestyle.
Amy used to be a part of that scene before we came to the United States.
Amy
in
je bila
Seattle.
Dio te scene iz Seattle, prije što su oni stigli.
Amy je...
I was playing with a drummer from Pearl Jam. You know, we recorded, we performed concerts.
Svirala je, snimala sa bubnjare Pearl Jam.
Matt Cameron.
Njen prvi band je bio onaj Fila Basta, on je svirao u grupi Top Dogs.
Kulturni šok. Jeste li vi u nekoj glazbenoj misiji? Koga želite predstavljati?
I have some sort of music mission. Who do you want to represent?
Mm-hmm. Well, it depends. I guess we're talking about the grunge era Seattle bands and stuff like this. The band is kind of complicated.
Obzirom da govorimo o grunge eri u Seattlu, postanak benda je u stvari komplicirana na jedan način.
Because we, foreigners in the band, landed in Seattle maybe the 5 years between 91 and 96. And,
jer mi koji smo stranci stigli smo Seattle u periodu 91. do 96.
And we are displaced by different reasons. Like Gino and Mari for one reason, I immigrated for a different reason, but in a way we connected with a local scene.
Svi su došli iz različitih razloga, recimo Vali došao iz Bugarske kao druga vrsta imigranta za razliku od Marija i Gine.
So in a way, what we're doing is as much a result of what Seattle in the mid-90s used to be, as it is result of immigration, which is a common American phenomenon.
Tako da ovo što je Ben danas je rezultat njegovog iskustva dolaska u Seattle i nastavak te scene u Seattle, kao i rezultat njegovog ličnog iskustva kao imigranata, što je običan fenomen.
Jednim dijelom ste već odgovorili na moje sljedeće pitanje, koje bi otprilike glasilo: da li ste vi samo vizualno marketinška konstanta ili ste ipak glazbena terapija? kao odgovor na osjećaj tjeskobe, nelagodne, nesigurnosti i zbunjenosti koji je dijagnosticiran kod mladih ljudi sa ovih područja ili kod mladih ljudi vaše publike kad svirate u Hrvatskoj, Srbiji, Bosni i Hercegovini, Crnoj Gori?
Definitivno, meni je jako lako odgovoriti na ovo pitanje, zato što je to u stvari pitanje, definicija po Websterovom rječniku, onaj kulturnog šoka, što znači da je to stanje anksioznosti, zbunjenosti novoga, nove osobe koja, odnosno štijeli emigranta koji ili ti osobe koja se nalazi u novoj izložene utjecaju nove kulture. Mi smo to samo okrenuli u principu da skontamo da je to stanje anksioznosti i dezorientacije lokalnog stanovništva izlaženo do novoj kulture koja je dolazi od nekog drugog. Kao što Val reče, mi smo došli iz različitih razloga. Oni mariju stvari, su me mnogo više, oni su njih dvojica su došli kao imigranti. Ja sam došao na kulturnu razinu, masa je došao na drugačije kao student, znaš, iz Japana. Tako da, međutim, spojila nas je ista stvar. Kad si novi negdje, ti se, svako, sad se jedan od nas se bavio rock and rollom, ako možemo tako da kažemo, rock muzikom, alternativnom muzikom, pop muzikom, svime što nije etničko i naše kad smo bili kući. Onog momenta kad smo došli, osjetili smo potrebu da svoje kulturno nasljeđe izrazimo kroz ono što imamo, što najbolje znamo, to znači da sviramo. Ne bi mi palo napraviti ovu vrstu muzike da sviram još živim sami.
Vi ipak uspjevate kroz vaš nastup, izvedbu, tu, vašoj publici vratiti izgubljeni identitet.
Basically, you attempt through your music and through your performances to give back the lost identity to your audience.
I wouldn't say that. Our lives are pretty complicated because, as Gino has mentioned before, we cannot find a place in the world where we belong. Because every time we are over there, Seattle is our home, but we long for what's going on here. And every time we're here, we long for what's back home and our friends, families, and lives over there. And neither one of the places is perfect enough. So it's not necessarily giving back, you're just confused. You're just confused and you don't know where we are.
But we're honest in that confusion and we really don't care how that comes out. It's just like it's coming out.
Ne bih potpuno rekla da se studiraju, znači više se radi o tome da oni kad su svjetlo osjećaju se kao kod kuće, a opet ljude za onim što su ostali u svojim kućama da su potekli. Dakle, se ne radi više o vraćanju tog identiteta, nego su oni sami zbunjeni u svemu tome. Kako Gino kaže, on kad su iskreni i pošteni, to je svoje zbunjenost.
Evo, ovog ja dođem, Mi u našem bandu smo apsolutni izuzetak. Mi imamo najbolje i najgore od oba dva svijeta. Obično, ti govoriš o publici, o tako, onaj, mislim, kultur šok prvo, da se razumije, je nastao zato što smo htjeli da se mi osjećamo dobro, a ne publika. I do dana današnjeg tako radimo.
Moje sljedeće pitanje je upravo u tom pravcu. Dakle,
samo da završim ovo, jer mislim da je ovo jako bitno. Ma ona izreka sljedeće godine u Izraelu, tako se osjećam. Kad ljudi koji su u inostranstvu žele da su kući, a oni koji su kod kuće žele da su inostranstvu, u isto vrijeme jedni i drugi su, nedostatak bolje riječi, ljubomorni, zavide onome što ovi drugi imaju. Ovi kod kuće zavide na materijalnom blagostanju, ovi odavde zavide na domovini i na svemu onome što oni nemaju u tom momentu. I jedni i drugi pate, nesretni su. A mi smo u zraku i patimo zajedno s njima. ne znamo gdje se nalazimo i ne znamo gdje nam je dom, sad nam je dobro tako koliko ćemo tako živjeti, nema pojma. Ali definitivno jedini dom u kojem ja se najbolje osjećam u avionu. Iz nekog razloga. Ne, ovo bolo, objašnjavajte psihijatri.
Super. Kad se neko nađe u publici, neko sa strane, neko posmatra tu publiku, ona nakon vaših koncerata izgleda smrljeno. Jer s toliko energije, gnjeva i bijesa se vi izručite po njima.
Gnjeva i bijesa. Gnjeva i bijesa. Ovo mi se sviđa, ovo će pjesmu.
We thought it's a love.
Mi smo mislili da je to ljubav, ali eto sad. Ti gnjevi i bijesa, ajde dobro. I dobro, hvala.
Ja na neki način tako vidim otprilike tu cijelu stvar za vašu publiku.
The way you see the thing you have in the audience is that after your concert, one of them from the side, they can see that the audience comes out really smashed.
Exhausted
after your concert because of all of the rage and anger. So it was the third word issue.
That's what I was saying.
Spill out on the
drama.
Yeah, it was great. That was my thought.
We come together, we all respect each other very greatly, we all have a lot of experience as musicians. Together we create this synergy, that's this combination of Eastern and Western traditions, and we put it out with all of zutzen, with the most, with heart, yeah, and it's coming back in our concerts. There's not so much rage, maybe the music sounds angry, but it's...
No, it's all Gino, he's raging.
With every passing year, we're feeling more and more this circle of love, and that our concerts create communities.
Maybe you should change the frontman. Yeah, they're good. You know, if they change the frontman, they definitely would have done better, much better out there in United States and Germany, because, you know, having the last name, and the first time I thought that people are shitting me when they were saying, like, yeah, you know, you'll see with your last name and your first name with your accent how Anglo-Saxons are going to respond. But then, you know, then I realized, yeah, I mean, if I'm from Denver, everything would be much, much, much easier. But we would never be here.
We would sound like people.
And we would not, and we would sound differently, and we would never, you know, capitalize on my pop career over here.
And I hate.
Dobro, dozvolit ćete da se vratimo sad muzici. Gypsy Punk, dakle, stil koji svirate.
No.
Je neki mix hard rocka, punka, metal rocka. U autorskom smislu, molim vas, kako je to glazbena kreacija? Poznato mi je da imate i publiku u Americi. Na koji način oni reagiraju na one vaše hitove? Šeitan, Zumbu, Tamni Vilajet, Akšan, Ramo Ramo, Mujo Kuje. Kad te pjesme izvodite u Americi i američka publika, da li sva ta kongres?
Does the audience in the United States understand the context of your songs, which for
the
area here essentially?
Of course not. The rank and file Americans, they have no idea about what's going on lyrically, but then they get sucked by the energy, by the unusual rhythmics and the melodics and the passion with which Gino Delivers work with us, and the fact that we're playing our hearts out, because most of the bands in the Western world do not play their hearts out. There's nothing there. There's nothing
they there. Play to be rich and famous. You know, that's the focus. And we kind of, we're too old for it.
Yeah, and in addition, I'm mentioning here that they try to group us and to package us into the Gypsy Punk phenomenon or whatever, but we are not pop enough for that. That's for people that care about easy listening and getting out and dancing or festivals with mid-tempo songs. We don't do that. We just play it and rock it out, and that's why we do not fit into this this whole conceptual movement or whatever the hell.
Onih godina kad sam odrastao ovdje i onda samo odrastao sam i dan danas sam tu, više sam tu nek sam tam. Mi isto tako dolazimo na koncerte anglosaksonskih bendova i slušamo ne samo na engleskom nego i na njemačkom i na šta ja znam i na francuskom bendove i tako da niko ne razumije riječ, a svi su svima dobro. Mislim, muzika nije nešto što... Muzika je kao slika, kao abstraktna slika koju gledaš i imaš na zidu zato što se lijepo osjećaš. A za mene, za tebe predstavlja šta god treba da predstavlja. Ako ti je lijepo, ti ćeš se staviti na sliku. Šta je pisac htio da kaže je ostalo u osnovnoj školi, to više nema.
It's like listening to music from Mali or something like that. Do I know what the hell they're saying? I have not the faintest idea, but the beat and the delivery and the groove that they have just sucks you in and makes you part of the whole thing. You know that they are honest, you know that they mean it.
I na neki način ljudi razumiju, jer tekstove koje ja pišem, tekstovi nisu baš najjednostavniji da razumiju, čak i ako si odavde. Ponekad se bavim arhaičnim bosanskim jezikom, ponekad radim ovo, ponekad se totalno abstraktno. Međutim, ja imam osjećaj da je energija sa kojom mi to predstavimo, u principu izravna sve to, ljudi to razumiju. Važno je kako se osjećaš poslije toga, a meni je bitno da se izrazi.
Izdali ste album Live in America. Poznato vam je...
Ovaj zadnji misliš?
Da.
Live at home, Live in America je bio prvi.
Dakle, poznato vam je da na neki način to je san svih mladih ljudi koji su
na neki način vaša publika.
Kako je živjeti jedna muzičar, aktivna muzičar danas?
That's a great question for
Masa. You released the album Live in America, the first one, and then Live at Home,
yeah,
the last one. So how is it to be a musician in the United States and to live this story as a musician in the United States?
Survive.
It is very difficult, you know, none of us really make, there's no middle class in music business, I feel like it's just take all or nothing, so it is very difficult, but we love what we do, and we just have to survive, Amy's same way, living, music, there's a lot of musicians struggling, even though they're super talented. There's no money.
In America, there's not the same respect for musicians that I find in many places in Europe. It's not as deep a part of the culture. It's something to consume. It's not that you're an artist. It's
personalization.
Moja definicija rock'n'rolla danas je da je rock'n'roll samo za bogata društva.
If you allow his definition of rock'n'roll is that it is designed only for rich societies.
Well, it's getting even worse than that. Because right now, if you are a young man, no matter if you're in the Western world or in the European South, Southeast, you cannot really break into the scene very easily because the whole music industry system has completely collapsed in the last few years through democratization of the listening sources. But there's no defined cash stream that can support talent. So if you're a young band, you have to pay and you have to produce music, but there's no return. So you cannot actually promote it. There's no financial vehicle to do that. And on the other hand, I see promoters not taking any risks and any chances on young talent. So young talent ended up being trapped. We were kind of lucky to be one of the last waves band in which we can establish ourselves before all these things went to complete and shit.
It's over with Vlad, isn't it?
Moje sljedeće pitanje jest u tom pravcu. Dakle, 2008. godine ste osnovali svoju vlastitu domaću Culture Shock Records. Jesu li samo umjetnički razlozi ili i poslovni su vas natjerali na taj pod?
Oba.
Was it only business or music reasons that made you found your own? Oba dvoje. Ovako ja to vidim. Muzika kao biznis i kao umjetnost se promijenila. Nekad je ono, to bilo normalno, imaš radio, imaš televiziju, imaš diktorske kuće, nema posla bez radija i televizije i diktorskih kuća koji ti omogućavaju pristup na radio i televiziju. Sad nema nikakve veze, sad imaš kompjutere i onaj, jedino što ti diktorska kuća omogućuje jeste štampanje CD-ova, to možeš i sam. Sad više ne štampaju CD-ovi, sad u principu ti uzimaju pare, daju ti avans za $200,000, koji to ono, nije dovoljno da po auto kupimo sebi svaki, onaj, i kažu ti kad ćeš izdat ploču i onaj, koliko treba da čekaš ako oni kažu da ne izdaješ, ne izdaješ ploču, ne izdaješ ploču. Tako da mladi bendovi potpišu ugovor onaj, i raspadu se. I drže ih na klupi, pošto tu izdaju drugo, kao ko kad kupiš mladog igrača pa ga držiš na klupi, da bi onaj, da ne bi igrao za nekoga drugog. Eto, to je to. Mi smo samo to izbjegli, imali smo ludu sreću da smo naše prvi, koliko ploče, četiri ploče izdali za Cool Arrow Records, koji je vlasništvo našeg prijatelja Billya Boulda iz grupe Fake No More, koji nam je u principu savjetovao i rekao, ja sam vam sve dao što mogu da vam dam, sad u ovom momentu ste veći nego što on može da pretrpi, onaj, hoćete li, i bila je ponuda za taj, tu diskografsku kućku, u principu ništa nudilo, ono, ajde, mi ne budemo predstaviti što ćemo biti tu, mome i majice. I evo, onaj, mislim da je to razlog. U principu je to razlog. I ajde recimo da je sve to bilo tako, da se san dogodio, da smo mi krenuli svirati po stadionima. Koliko ti dugo možeš svirati po stadionima? I godinu i pol dana, jer zato što je fokus generalne publike, mainstream publike, tako da je zovemo, godinu i pol dana, poslije toga dođu mlađi, ljepši, drugačiji, tako dalje, i ti su zapičku. Nervni slomovi, bend se raspada. Ili se drže na klupi, bend se raspada. U svakom slučaju, bend se raspada. Jedini način da se postoji 20 godina, od 96. do dana današnjeg ovog, i da se izda 10 ploča, 2 DVD-a, filmovi da se prave, onaj, šta ja znam, onaj, kako se zove, onaj, Južnjaci marš, Čepuri Rauš, makedonski ovaj, Milčo Mančevski, da će filmove pravi sa tvojom muzikom, jedini način da to uradiš, toliko i toliko dugo postojiš da budeš svoj i da imaš svoje ljude. Jer ovi ljudi koji ćeš večeras biti ovdje, oni neće nigdje otići. Ukoliko se mi ne promijenimo, ukoliko mi ne izdamo njih, to je, i to je to, mi njima sviramo, ne generalno.
Kad smo se ponovo dotakli, namjera mog intervjua, ali mi je upravo to da publika sazna šta dobija ako se prepusti kulturnom šoku.
His intention is to show to the potential audience with this interview what they can experience in a concert if they decide to
attend. Izaziva to je doista kulturni šok ili je to samo zdravstvena dijagnostika?
Do you really call them a cultural shock, or is it a medical diagnosis?
Both. It just depends where the audience is coming from. Has never been exposed to even one of the musical phenomena in Western or Eastern, of course they're going to be surprised by what I'm going to hear, because it's all mixed and mishmashed in what we do. But what is happening is we've been kind of lucky and we can build our performances in a way that they never in a way a healing experience because of the connection that goes between us and the public out down in front of the stage. It's a two-way street. We give, they give, and we cleanse ourselves that way. It's not just a healing experience for them, it's a healing experience for us because we feel. We feel when the people are into it and they participate actively in it. It helps us get from day to day because we are on the road and all sorts of shit is happening. Most of it is not good. So when we have a show in which we connect with the audience like this, we just like, you know, that endorses what we're doing, that justifies all the sacrifices and suffering that the world kind of makes us suffer.
Because the potential of music is that it's a unifying force. And I feel like this, we see it at all of our concerts, that all these strangers come together and everyone is together, even though they may not agree politically, they may not agree culturally. At that moment, when there's this music and there's this circulation of sound, it's a beautiful thing.
I was looking the other night, you're playing the Power Music Festival in there was this castle courtyard, really jagged, like cobblestones on the ground, and there was like a very serious mosh pit going on. And of course, in these kind of circumstances, people fall down, there's a potential hurt and stuff. And the kids stop, help each other, pull each other up in order to get back into the mosh. You know, it's helping, it's not violent, it's not, you know what I mean?
Yes. That was Namašem. To je jedna od najljepših kritika koju sam ja čuo, neka beogradska novinarka kad smo mi svirali u Beogradu je napisala, kaže, ja sviđa mi se publika kultu, može on kako. Kaže, nisu toliko klinci koliko su obično na rokoncima. To je ona publika koja poslije mošpita, poslije onaj guranja, jedan drugi se izvinjaje jedan drugi što su proveli pivu. Kao što vi molite, treba da kupi, tako. Znaš, to je to. Nama je čast da sviram. Ja ne znam da se ja sam ali znam jednu stvar, mi njima damo sve, mi njima damo sve što imamo, oni tamo daju svoju ljubav, oni tamo daju svoju ljubav.
I za kraj ovog intervjua jedno ovako još generalno pitanje, mada iskreno volio bi da ženski dio benda da podijeli svoju glazbenu mudrost sa svama, ovo sa koncerata koji...
He would like to, as the female part of the band, especially, to share your musical wisdom with us.
People always say, I play saxophone. People say, oh, it must be so difficult to be a woman in the music industry. I don't regard sexuality as... I regard myself as a musician, and I happen to be a woman. So I in a way, I'm a feminist in that I simply do what I do. I don't judge. I don't say, "Oh, poor me." Although it depends on the situation. The other day we were coming to Novigrad, and I came out of the band, and later the organizer said to me, "Oh, I'm so sorry. I see that you do play, but I thought you were just a wife of one of the musicians." And she said, "I've been feminist my whole life, fighting for the rights of women, and I'm instantly saying, oh, there's the wife."
She was mad at herself.
Yeah, she was really mad at herself. Like, God, I'm really trying to change my own mentality, and I see that it's difficult. But anyway, my point is that we all play, and I love to set a very strong example as a woman who plays. And that's all.
Samo da kažem da je Amy između sviju nas najpoznatiji muzičar širom svijeta, jer ona ide i pravi svoje koncerte po Italiji i velika je zvijezda, tako da i Francusko i tako da. Amy u principu napravila sama svoje ime. A kulturno se predlužao već kao zreo muzičar, pa se mogu.